Hey guys, my name is Ainslie-Marie Pitkis and welcome to or welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I'm going to be doing a book cover challenge. So, I don't know if you guys have heard of Book Outlet, but it is this amazing book discount store. It's online though. I'll put the link in the description if you guys want to go check it out. That's where I get probably the majority of my books because it's such a great website. Anyway, something that they do is they offer points and, you know, X amount of points gets you this. One of those things that offers to give you more points is a loyalty quiz. You can only take them once a month. And so I was just taking, you know, May's monthly quiz that, you know, I like taking them. They're fun. It's like a BuzzFeed quiz. Like, it's really fun. So I was taking that, and usually at the end, it will recommend a book for you, which is awesome. However, this one recommended me to do a book cover challenge because in the quiz, I had shown signs of like buying books based off of the covers, which is so accurate. I can't even, oh my goodness. I know people say don't judge a book by its cover, but here I am doing it all the time. Oops. Anyway, so there's four challenges, and with that, I'm going to be doing four books. The first challenge is to read a book that you bought based on the cover, and like I've said before, most of my books I buy because of the cover. So with this one, I was like, what can we do? And I thought, you know, May is Mental Health Awareness Month, so this book I chose, this book is What I Lost by, is it Alexandra? Yeah, by Alexandra Ballard, and it follows a girl who has a eating disorder, and obviously Mental Health Month, eating disorder, let's go. So this is what I'm going to be doing to cover that challenge. Oops. So the next book I'm going to be reading is The Hazelwood, and this completes the challenge. Read a book with a animal on the cover. I thought that this one was going to be like the easiest challenge to complete. It wasn't. This one and another book, I don't know which one, had an animal on the cover, but I wanted to read this one more. So this is The Hazelwood by Melissa Albert. Next challenge is to read a book that starts with the letter of your name. With my name starting with A, obviously, a lot of titles start with A blank, you know, all of that stuff. So I was like, you know, this is going to be really easy. But I was like, no, we're not going to be basic. We're not going to be normal. We're going to choose a legitimate word. So I looked at my TBR card and I found the book After, and I found the book Alex Approximately. And I was like, you know, I envision myself reading After on the beach, and I'm not at the beach yet. So I chose Alex Approximately because and this is written by Jenn Bennett. So that completes that challenge. I'm really excited to read it. Last year, I know I read about like 20 pages, and because I was so busy with schoolwork and applying to college, I put it down. So let's pick it back up for the challenge. And the final challenge is going to be read a book that has your favorite color on the cover. And this one I recently got because of my Bookcase Club subscription. It is Little and Lion. My favorite color is mint green. And my second one, depending on the day, is this pink. It looks a little brighter on the camera, but it's not. Focus. Thank you. So yeah, this one, obviously it has both, and the spine is my favorite, my all-time favorite color. We're going to go in order because I know that if I don't go in order, I'm going to spend more time debating which book to start than I am actually reading the books. I don't know if that's just me, but yeah, so let's go ahead and get into it. Okay guys, so I am 25 pages in. I don't know where my book is. I'm 25 pages into What I Lost, and I am now going to go upstairs and read in our little, we have a screened in porch, and we also have like this like hangy hammock chair thing. I don't really know what it's called, but I'm gonna go read for a good hour or two there, and I'll see you guys when I'm done. Okay guys, so I just finished reading about 150 pages in my book. Mom, do you want to get in the... We are going to get dinner. My mom was craving some lasagna. So I'm getting fettuccine Alfredo there too.
We're fine with this.
And we're taking Roxy. We're taking precious Roxy with us. So I'll talk to you guys later. I hope it's focused on my face, because if it's not, I'm sorry. Okay guys, so last night I ate dinner with the family and then I watched, I think, like 3 movies. Are we sure it's focused on my face? So I watched 3 movies last night. I didn't read any more in my book. And then I woke up this morning, I worked out, I took a shower, I ate breakfast, I read a little bit, and then I went to Taco Bell to get a Baja Blast. Love it. And then now I'm out here tanning with the dog. Say hi. Say hi, baby. Say hi, baby. Not to me. To the camera. To the camera. To the camera, babe. Okay, but I have about, let's see, how many pages do I have left? I'm on 205 and I think there's like 360. I don't know where you're going, but you're not going to get very far. So I don't know if I'm going to finish the book or I'm going to get super close. Oh wait, just kidding. I'm on page 285. Wow, I don't know what happened there, but something happened. Okay, I seriously hope that this is in focus. Well, anyway, I'm going to go read and I'll check in with you guys when I'm done. Soaking up. I'm already getting hot and I haven't even been out here for 5 seconds. Oh my god. Roxy, what are you looking at? Roxy. Roxy! Whatever. 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 Good morning, friends. So yesterday I did finish What I Lost, but after I did that, I took a nap for 5 hours. And then obviously I was not feeling like reading anything after that. So I've been slumped since yesterday at about 5. So that's really awesome, right? Anyway, so I decided to give this book a 4.5. I don't know why I'm out of it today, because I got a sufficient amount of sleep, so I don't know what I'm doing. Anyway, I gave this book 4.5 stars. I thought it was really good. I actually took some notes, so let me pull them up on my phone just so that I cover all the different parts that I want to cover. Here is my review. I don't know if it's going to focus, but that's my review on Goodreads. If you guys want to go follow me on Goodreads, see what I'm doing, anything like that, my link will be in the description down below. So, what I said for this book, I'm not sure how accurate the eating disorder part was. For me, I have been in a mental hospital before, so some of the things that happened in here happened to me, so I was like, that's so true. Like, yeah, I remember that happening. Like, for instance, no matter what you're in there for, they do count what you eat, what utensils you use, all of that stuff, which I thought is weird, but if you think about it, it kind of makes sense. Obviously, because they have eating disorders, it's a little bit different, but yeah. I also really liked, how we got to, like, see her thoughts evolve. How we got to see her thoughts, like, evolve through the book. I thought that was really awesome. Oh my god. I thought it was really awesome to see, especially, like, it is really true what they say. Like, until you accept the fact that you do need help, you're not gonna get better. And I think that this book does a really, really good job of showing that. Also, I really appreciate the fact that there was representation for a lot of the eating disorders. For example, all the books that I read, like, there's obviously, like, a side character who has an eating disorder, and that's totally fine, you know? I love that. But it's usually the anorexic kind. It usually focuses more on anorexia. For this one, there was representation of bulimia, and I really do appreciate that, because I feel like bulimia is such a different type of eating disorder. Like, you wouldn't recognize it as an eating disorder. And I really like that she took the time to cover every part of eating disorders. Like, I really like that. Also, there was, like, a romance plot but it didn't take over the normal plot, you know? Like, I like that there was, like, little hints of it everywhere, but it wasn't, like, ah! If you know what I'm saying, that makes no sense. How I just described it actually makes no sense. But I like the fact that this book stayed true to the eating disorder getting help plot and didn't let the relationship, romance, all of that stuff cover it, if that makes sense. Like, it was just peppered in every now and then. It was a really nice touch. All that was just good. So I ended up giving this book 4.5 stars. The only reason why I decided to do that was because usually whenever it's a 5-star read, you know that it's a 5-star read. And I feel like with this one, I wasn't sure if I wanted to give it the whole 5, but it also didn't deserve just a 4. So I gave it 4.5. Of course, on Goodreads, it's going to show up as a 4 because they don't do the 0.5 stuff, which I'm actually going to email them later today and be like, you need to give us that option because that's all I do. The next book that I'm going to read is, or the next challenge that I'm going to try to do is read a book with an animal on the cover. Looking at my TBR card, I thought that I was going to have so many books with animals on them, and I don't. So, what? Anyway, Strange the Dreamer and The Hazelwood were the only two that I could find that actually had an animal on it, which is kind of sad. But it's okay. Right there. There's a bird. So, it counts, which is awesome. Honestly, I don't really know what it's about. I don't like to read, like, fantasy books unless... Like, I don't like to read the synopsis of fantasy books, I mean. Oops. Okay, I'm just gonna read it to you guys. 17-year-old Alice Proserpine and her mother have spent most of Alice's life on the road, always a step ahead of the uncanny bad luck biting at their heels. But when Alice's grandmother, the reclusive author of a book of pitch-dark fairy tales, dies alone on her estate, the Hazelwood... Oh, where was I? Wow, I need to stop doing that. Alice learns how bad her luck can really get. Her mother is stolen away by a figure who claims to come from the cruel, supernatural world where her grandmother's stories are set. Alice's only lead is the message her mother left behind. Stay away from the Hazelwood. Dang. Okay, sister. I'm really interested to read this book now. I think I'm gonna go dive into it, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye! Hey guys, so it's been a couple hours since I last talked to you guys. Last that you guys heard, I was starting The Hazelwood. I read for about 30 minutes, and now I am on page 92. And then I, of course, took another 3-hour nap. So, this book, you know, it's okay. I'm 100 pages in. The storyline has just started. Don't know how I feel about that. Honestly, I'm not really connecting with the characters or with the plot, or just I'm not really vibing with it yet. It is 10:30, so I'm gonna read until around midnight or until I get super tired and just can't take anymore. I will check in with you guys either after I'm done reading or if I finish it. I'll just check in with you guys later. So talk to you later. Bye.
Roxy. Oh, you're so cute.
Okay, so I officially have a little less than 100 pages to go in the book. And you know, if I really wanted to, I know for a fact that I could finish this book within less than an hour. But I am someone who gets scared super easily. So this book is kind of scaring me just a little bit. And by a little bit, I mean I was too scared to, like, leave my room to go get a cheese stick. So, yeah, I'm actually about to... What is up with this lighting? So I'm about to just do my bullet journal, cuddle with my dog. I'm currently watching the TV show Virgin River. And by the time this vlog is over, Well, I've already finished it, so I'm gonna go watch some of that, and I'll check in with you guys later. Bye! Good morning, friends. As you can tell, I am already tired, and I've only been awake,
It's currently 10:20 and I've been up since 10:30, so that's great. Starting off strong. I just got out of the shower and I'm wearing yoga pants, so it's gonna be one of those days. Here, let me turn around and show you guys what the weather looks like. So it's not the prettiest. Swell. So, like I said last night, I have about, I think, 80 pages left in the book, so I'm gonna give that a read, and then I'm going to give you guys my review. My cousin texted me. Let's see what she has to say. Tell Yaya happy birthday. Oh yeah, I forgot. So guys, today is my grandmother's birthday, so I am not going to get much reading done, only because, you know, as you get older, it could be your last birthday and all that stuff, and plus I love her, so I'm gonna try to spend a good majority of the day annoying her. But yeah, and since it's so early in the morning, I don't think I'm gonna pick up another book like right after this, only because I need some time to process. I don't know if that's just me. I usually finish books at night, and so I sleep. And whenever I wake up, I'm like, okay, done with the book, time for the next one. But whenever I finish a book in the morning, I don't like starting one directly after, which is why I don't really do the 24-hour readathons, only because whenever I read the first book and then I immediately go into the second book, I feel like I don't have a strong connection with the second one because my thoughts are still stuck in the first one. So that's just my two cents. I'm gonna go read my book and I'll see you guys when I'm done with the review. Okay guys, so I finished the Hazelwood earlier today, and I'm sorry to say it guys, but I'm giving this one 2 stars. There's not a lot that I could say. I was honestly going to give it 1 star, but I felt like that was a little mean because this book, it did make me feel things. Like I said last night, it did make me scared. Like, it made me a little uncomfortable just to be, like, sitting in the quiet. So, because it did make me feel things, I did not appreciate the feelings. I had to give it 2. But the reason why I could not give it more was because, I feel like the pacing was way off. Like, it was either super slow. Like, the beginning was so slow, and then the ending, it was so fast. And, oh, I just yawned. And I feel like there was very little balance between the beginning and the ending. Like, I feel like the pacing was just way off, and I could not get into it because of that reason. Also, the characters were really flat and they didn't really go, like, they didn't mesh well together. And then there was some talk about betrayal, but they didn't really go into detail about it. There were a ton of flashbacks, and I just feel like the transitions weren't really helping the situation, like, at all. So, it's not for me, and that's okay. So, sadly, I will not be continuing with the series, because I think there is a second one, The Cursed Night, something like that, I don't know, but yep, this is gonna be the last book for me. Maybe I'll read more by Melissa Albert, but that's probably doubtful, because usually if the first book is a low rating, I try to stray away from those authors. So yeah, for the next challenge, it was to pick a book that starts with the same letter as your name. Obviously, my name starts with A, so I could have chosen any book that starts with A, duh. But I wanted to challenge myself. I was like, no, you're actually gonna pick like a legit word. And I have so many choices on my TBR cart. Sorry guys, I'm actually so tired. But the next one I'm going to be picking up is Alex Approximately. And I did start to read this last summer, but then school started and I got super swamped with, you know, trying to do my work, starting college applications and all that stuff. I ended up having to return it to the library. And then my mom gave me a Book Outlet gift card. And this was the first thing that I put in my cart. So yeah, I have not read any books by Jenn Bennett yet, but I know a lot of my friends on BookTube have read stuff by her, or they've read this book and they really enjoyed it. They recommended it to me. So I'm excited. We're just gonna dive right in. Hey guys, so I'm sorry that this is the only update that you guys are gonna get from me. I woke up and I was not feeling pretty good. As you can tell by my hair and my outfit, it just has not been a good day. Everything was fine. It's just my allergies decided to hit hard and I've been sneezing. It hasn't been ideal. But while I was not feeling good, I picked up this book I've read it on and off today. I started reading Alex Approximately, and guys, I love this book. I am only, what page am I on? I'm on page 161, and I'm about to just go sit in my chair, ignore the mess, but I'm about to go sit in my chair and just read to my heart's content for maybe an hour. But yeah, I will check in with you guys tomorrow. Bye. So, you know that 1 to 2 hour of reading time? It turned into 3. I have just finished 5 freaking stars. Oh my god, I love everything about this. The only thing that I had a problem with was how stupid Bailey was at the ending. I was like, then again, I'm going into criminal justice and people say that I tend to think outside the box, and I think because she was really dumb and really slow, I was like, girlfriend, what are you, like, what is going on in your head right now? Because that's the only downside that I had to this book. Other than that, adorable, utterly adorable. The description that went into this book, I was like, okay, sis. I told my parents, I was like, oh my god, I feel like I'm at the beach. Like, I feel like I'm actually watching surfing happen. You know, maybe I'll start watching old time movies. Probably not though, because I don't know. So I don't know if you ever like read books and you get so invested in it, you love it so much, you just put your heart and soul into it, that you think it's a movie. I don't know if that's me, but this book, oh my god, guys, seriously, if you haven't picked it up, please, for the love of god, go pick it up. I am so mad at past Ainslie. Okay, sister Ainslie, who was living life in August of 2019, who prioritized her schoolwork over this. And your schoolwork, sis, doesn't even matter because of COVID. Sis, you missed out and you're an idiot. Ainslie-Marie of August 2019, you're dumb.
Hey guys, so it's currently Thursday night and Roxy and I are here. We're about to, oh my goodness, you've gotten big. We are about to watch a movie. Which one are we watching? She can't answer. We're going to be watching Walk, Ride, and Rodeo. And by we're going to watch, I mean, I'm going to watch. She's going to go to bed. Little girl's tired. Okay. Okay, baby. Also, my best friend Mads came by today. She knew that I was having kind of a rough day and just wanted to surprise me because she's literally amazing. She dropped off my favorite Starbucks drink, a cookie, and then she went to Taco Bell and dropped off my favorite Taco Bell Baja Blast drink with, I think they're called cinnamon twists, which are really good, by the way. So good that Grandma P stole them. Roxy, you look like a beast in the shadow. Okay. So we're gonna go vibe with the movie. And I'm gonna go attempt to drink this. So, see you guys tomorrow. Bye. Hey guys, so it's been a hot second since I last filmed. I think the last time I talked to you guys was about a week ago, and I had just finished Alex Approximately. Well, the day after Alex Approximately, think I took a day off of reading, but then come in. Do you want to say hi to the vlog?
Hi, sorry.
You can come in, it's okay. Okay guys, I'm back now. We just had to talk about something. Anyway, so like I said, I took a day off after I finished my last book, and then I read Little and Lion. Guys, this book, what was it? It took me, I started it one day, and then I waited a day, and then I finished it, and it was really good. I don't really remember. I mean, obviously, you guys are more than welcome. Go check out my Goodreads, because I write all of my review the day after, or I try my hardest to write my review exactly the day after that I finish the book, just so, like, my thoughts are fresh, and I can write down every little detail while I still remember it. So, back to Little and Lion. So, I love this book. I liked how it covered bisexuality. I feel like a lot of books don't necessarily capture the thought process that goes into it. They don't really dive into how, like, what bisexuality really is. Like, it's not a pit stop going from straight to gay. Like, it's not that, you know, like, it's a legitimate thing. And I think this book does a good job of, you know, the thought process of how you get there, and how it's really not accepted. You know, if you're bisexual, you're too gay for the straight community, but you're too straight for the gay community. And I don't think that's right. This book does a great job capturing that. I've never read a book where one of the main characters was bipolar. You know, I've read books where, like, the mom was, or an ex-best friend, you know, something like that, but never a main character. And I think the book also did a really, really good job on capturing what it's like going off of your medication and how it not only affects you, but, like, it also affects everybody around you. As much as you want to say it doesn't, it does, you know? I don't know. I think this book did so good, capturing, you know, both LGBTQ and also the mental health stuff. So May is Mental Health Month, and then June is, Pride. Just awesome. You know, I love it. Also, I just got my nails done. I could go like that. Anyway, yeah. So sorry if I'm like, look at them. But okay, yeah. Anyway. Yeah. So yeah, this book, I ended up giving it 4 stars. I think whenever I read the synopsis, a lot of the things that they said that was going to be happening didn't really start until, like, the halfway point in the book, which is fine. I mean, you know, the first half of the book, it was good as well, you know? So I think if I didn't like the first half of the book, we would be having a different discussion. But the fact that I liked the beginning, and then I also really liked the ending, I think that's why I gave it 4. But the reason why I couldn't just fully go and give it the 5 was because it didn't start straight off the bat, and it took a second for us to get there. But I mean, other than that, I thought it was good. Alright guys, so that is going to be it for today's video. If you guys have made it this far, you might as well give it a like and a subscribe. Thank you guys so much for watching. Just as a little recap, I read What I Lost, that got 4.5 stars. I read The Hazelwood, that got 2 stars. I read Alex Approximately, I gave it a whole 5. And then I read Little and Lion, and I gave it 4. So, like I said, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next week. Bye!